celebrity naval man, Lieutenant Commander Ron Thatcher, will have the exacting task of microscopically examining these rafts for seaworthiness, to check and to ensure that no nautical catastrophe of titanic proportions will occur here today. Teresa Garlack, a leading light behind the organization of this raft race here today. And my, doesn't she look radiant in this flowing white dress which she has stitched herself especially for today. And now, here's the Curry's raft to be inspected. Crewed here today by four stout lads. You know, Tom, I wonder why they're wearing gloves. Perhaps in this electric atmosphere, they might cause a shock and make sparks fly. And if they do, you know, here's the Wiltshire Fire Brigade, ready to dampen things down a bit. And now, let's go with our intrepid photographer, Pete Carr, here, blithely unaware of the egg-throwing ordeal which he will shortly be facing from the town bridges. And here we see what is possibly one of the most controversial craft here on the river today, the Pride of JS, built by Master Brothers, a company with unique craftsman skills. Their raft has been constructed with this race in mind. Note her very trim lines, her gleaming paintwork, and not least her proud, smartly turned out crew, wearing their specially designed uniforms, created to prove that the age of grace, elegance, and sophistication has not been lost forever. Oh my word, what a sight. Final preparations now take place, only the open sea to battle against. Adrenaline flowing, a nervous Captain Yates anxiously goes through last minute checks. And as the fireboat departs onto the ocean, the crew do their last minute warming up exercises, and soon the moment of truth will come. There they go now, helped by men of the Young Leaders Regiment, slowly gliding into the cold waters of the Avon. The balloons attached to the mast providing a most novel aid to buoyancy, and glory be, she floats. And the This is the moment where all the months and years of training pay off, where training rooms, courses and visual aids are replaced by the harsh realities of life before the mast. And there's Bosun Harvey leaning on his pole like a Venetian gondolier. Not as easy a job as one might think. And I hope he won't be out for a duck today. Here's the Chippenham management boat, not quite so splendid as the area office entry, but reflecting their more modest budget. The National Bus Company from Wiltshire. I don't think they'll be stopping for passengers today. Just like normal. And finally, before I hand back to Tom Fleming for a word about the route, here, the wonder of Woolies, and they really do need them today.
Thank you, John. And now let's take a look at the route the Rafts will be taking today. From the starting grid of ropes and hawsers erected by men serving in Her Majesty's Royal Navy from the nearby barracks of HMS Royal Arthur. They will make their way upstream 150 yards to a marker buoy. They will then turn at the buoy and paddle with the current, conditions made all the more hazardous as the leaders ply their craft against the flow of those still attempting to reach the turning point. They pass under the starting grid, past the banks of hundreds of cheering well-wishers, under the little footbridge that links Monkton Park with St. Mary Street, site of the last remains of the Georgian medicinal spa at the Grove. Onwards they go, under the town bridge, once thought to have been designed by Brunel, but recently denied, the bridge being built in 1966 and carrying the A4 on its way to Bath. Leaving only 4 feet of clearance for our rafts today. The competitors will now have their first sight of the finishing line, with just 150 yards to go of a total distance of over a mile. The River Avon, taking its name from the Celtic word for river, rising in the foothills of the Cotswolds, cutting its way through the counties of Gloucestershire, Wiltshire and Avon, visiting a treasure house of fine towns, villages and cities, flowing for over 75 miles until it meets its end in the Bristol Channel and finally the Atlantic Ocean. An area of 891 square miles is drained of its natural waters to feed this river, thirsty for adventure, and today providing a playing surface for these men and women with hearts of oak and gut determination and a theatre stage for the benefit of those who prefer to watch. There can't be many in Chippenham who haven't come out today to witness this event. Nearly time for the start. The craft are now afloat. The signal for the off will be heralded by the trumpeters of the Air Training Corps as they play a royal fanfare. This will be closely followed by the starting signal itself of a maroon of red smoke. Forward, you little flotilla, how great your presence will be. Rousing start to this race there, given by the Air Training Corps, has got things going with a real bang. As the smoke clears to reveal the real action, we now move straight away to our man on the spot. In the committee boat, on the water, in the thick of it all, over to you, Michael O'Hare.
Well, it's quite a blustery day out here on the water, and I'm not quite certain went wrong there, but there's no holding them now as they go towards the country, and the first marker, it's Bay Engineering. Around the marker first, and then Flying Scotsman in trouble. Flying Scotsman's in trouble at the first, and Curries are in there as well. So is Walrus, and the Natwest Banker having trouble with their flowers, and it's still in anybody's race. But as they come towards the back of the start again, it's anybody's race, the boat's getting away from us, and the boat's going under control now, and it's going, and it's going.
Oh,
are, right at the very end of this race. The final obstacle is the town bridge. Rafts now just have to pass underneath it, and then the finishing line will unfold before them, identified for all by Britannia herself, standing on a perch high above the crowds, proudly waving a flag from the International Code of Signals. The blue and white checks of code letter N to signify there's no stopping them now. Her podium, dressed overall with a fine display of geraniums and petunias of mauve and white, supplied by Clifford's Hardware Store. The caution wind band on the hill behind provide a musical welcome to the captains and crew of these strange little craft.
And the large partisan crowd are enjoying the spectacle of Captain Yates and his crew, relaxed now, paddling strongly towards the finish. A magnificent effort, really, when you consider the handicaps they've been labouring under. And, oh, my word, there's real drama here now. Bosun Harvey has just taken an impromptu dip. Now the question, did he slip or was he pushed? And as the replay clearly showed, he lost his glasses in the effort. Bosun Harvey practices for the Olympic breaststroke final. Captain Yates seems to be overestimating his authority by attempting to walk on the water there. And here we see the final scenes. Scott's tractor dragging these last waterlogged craft from the Eternal River. Many have tried to defeat her, but only the few brave ones have succeeded. Well, farewell now from me, John Arlott, here on the banks of the River Avon, and over to Tom Fleming for the victory presentation.
Thank you, John. Now in the courtyard beside the river, refreshments continue to be served by an army of willing helpers, carrying on the tradition perhaps of Maud Heath, a local market girl who in the reign of Henry VII came from nearby Langley Borough to this town to sell her dairy produce, and when she died in 1474 left her money to the town to build a causeway of stone to link the villages of the Avon Valley with Chippenham. She is remembered locally by a simple inscription on a stone wall, reading, "Hither extended Maud Heath's gift, for where you stand is Chippenham's clift." But today, the people of Chippenham have extended their gifts, and money collected en route for the cancer research campaign is handed to officials. We cannot say how many rafts took part in today's event, but I counted them all out, and I counted them all back. And the crews are now changing from their icy wet clothes into their parade dress. Many of the spectators have addressed for the occasion, and a silence now descends on this gathering, eager to hear the results, and Stuart Bentley now starts with his address with some votes of thanks to those who made the event possible.
And they had a band up at the start, the Junior Leaders Regiment, the Navy, particularly the Sea Cadets and HMS Royal Arthur, and the invaluable help they've all given. And there are countless thousands, I would think, who we haven't mentioned there, who have done a lot of work to see this event takes place safely and in the best spirit, and it's been very good. Right, now we've got our lady here. I don't know if it's called a Royal Britannia or what. She's going to give her the prizes, and to announce the prizes, we've got a bit of a surprise for you, because we've actually got Prince Charles down to do it for us. The wife was here earlier on. She had to take the baby away. Do what things have to be done with babies. One of those things, I'm afraid. But anyway, we've got some rather wonderful prizes here. I'd like to start off by awarding the prize for the best dressed raft. If I can get that out better, I will. It's the best dressed raft. And the winners, we only have one prize in each category. And we've got special comment. Goodness me, what's happening? Here we are. Right. Now we have a special commendation, but no prize. A special commendation for both the Post Office and the NatWest Bank, who did very well indeed. And the winners of the best dressed raft and gave a lot of fun all the way along the route. And we've got a magnum of champagne for them. This is, of course, the Wiltshire Fire Brigade. Where is the Wiltshire Fire Brigade? Here they are. Jolly well done. Hey, come and get your magnum. I thought for a minute they'd gone to fire, but they don't. Look at that. Ooh, missed me. Well done, lad. And now we come to the speed competition. And the fastest. Well, in second place, and no prize for this, in second place was the Bray Social Club. And in third place was the Dirty Deeds. And that means that in first place we have the Bray Social Club's other team. So with that, I've come forward and get their magnum. There's somebody coming forward to get the magnum. Presenting the magnum of champagne to the King's Home, was it you say? Kingsmore Children's Home of Box. Very splendid gesture, sir. We'll see if they get it.
You will make a note of that, won't you? Mm.
And now we come to the first prize in the sponsorship category. And of course, this is the most important because all the money we've raised today will go forward to cancer research. Sainsbury's, if you didn't realise it, have got a sort of year campaign on to raise money for cancer. And I'm sure the efforts which everybody's put in to this event will benefit by a considerable amount. The gentleman coming here with a red and white striped shirt, he looks like he's going to give us a piece of paper.